Hello guys, and welcome to this video. And today's video, I'm making a little series that kind of explains or showcases the games that I would recommend you playing, or the favorite games that I like. It's more to not to promote the game in that sense, but it's if you're looking for a new game, or you might have seen it and you didn't know if you're gonna try it out, definitely watch this video, and you might want to play this game. And the first game I'm recommending, or one of my favorite games, is the game called Trove. And it's a free-to-play game that has an in-game shop. You might have heard about it. It's joinworld's game. It's a kind of an MMO, but it's also like a dungeon runner. It's a little like also Club Wahoo, if you know what that is, and Minecraft, because it has a building what's it called, style to it. Also, you can probably see it from the game itself. And I'm not gonna explain more in depth what the game is, but it's at least it's free to play, and I'm gonna make a little guide right now, just to what class. If you do try this game out, you see this video, and you want to try this game out, I'm gonna put a link in the description to where you can get it. Or you can just type in Trove, but I'm gonna put a link in there so you can find it pretty quickly. But I'm gonna make a little guide to which class you should get. And if you take up J here, that's selecting classes. And pretty simply, I'm gonna go through them really quickly on which one you should take and which one you shouldn't take. So the Chloromancer is a no-go. I would say this is a first class. This is not anything to do with best class or whatever. Just starting out to playing the game. They nicely enough of them, they made a trial run. You can try every class out until level 4, or maybe it's already level 4. I can't remember. Never mind. But you can at least only be level 4, so you can't even get their second. You can see down here has three abilities right here. These three abilities. The number 2 ability is kind of the ultimate. Normally that's the one that has the longest cooldown, but you can't get that on 5 before you're level 5, which is really weird, because some of the characters really come together when they use the second ability, number 2 ability. So I don't know why, but at least you can try to level 4 and see if it's something for you. But I want to say Chloromancer, not as a first class. The Lunar Lancer is definitely one of the first classes you should try, if you can, if you want to. The Lunar Lancer is kind of a spear guy. He has a throw, he has like a number 1 ability that does a lot of damage. His number 2 abilities buffs like the whole group and stuff like that. There's no grouping in that sense, but you can run with other people. Revenant, sorry. The Revenant is also a class, I would say, one of the first you should try, either the Lunar Lancer or the Revenant. Very tanky, lives off a lot of health and life regen and stuff like that. The same with the Lunar Lancer, is also very tanky. It's a kind of a hybrid damage thing. This is mostly just tanking. And everybody loves the Revenant because he's so tanky and he's very good in groups. So if you start out with that and build it up, a very good idea. Tomb Raider, no, I wouldn't take this guy. No, not take that guy. Boom Ranger is the one I'm having active right now. He is also very good as a first class. If you like throwing the bombs, and if you get a good sword and stuff like that, the sword is the best. He can both have bows and swords. So the sword is better when you're soloing, and bows are better for groups. But anyways, I think the Lunar Lancer and the Revenant is a little bit better, just like 0.1% better. But if you take the Boom Ranger, or you have taken the Boom Ranger, you are you're not wrong at all, if that makes any sense. So, Dragonlight, no. Gunslinger, no. Neon Ninja, no. Neon Ninja is really good as a second character or a third character. Me saying this is that you really want one of these three classes as your first class, to still start out with, to like grind yourself up to like Uberworld 6 at least, and you can farm that pretty fast. So you can get all the gems, and there's a lot of guides out there to how gems works, how class guides, how to build them, how to do whatever, right? But that's just so Neon Ninja is like a second or third, maybe more like a third, because his class gem, there's class gems in this game. You can see my one ability down here, Big Bomb. It has like a this around it. That means that I have the class gem for this class, and it now does something extra. And the same with the Neon Ninja. When he gets his, his class sometimes completely changes, or it becomes at least very much better. So, but he's really not strong leveling up. So you kind of want something else you can grind those things with, and then put on the thing. Candy Barbarian also is also. I wanna still say one of these are top three. These are top one, and this is like 1 point or something like 1.1 or something like that. And this is like 1.2, if you can say it like that. He's like a little bit under. His class gem is not that great, so that's why I'm putting him a little bit under, but. Definitely, if you have this guy, it's not a bad choice. Fae Trickster, no. I'm gonna jump over the Shadow Hunter for now, and then you have the Ice Age. The Ice Age is very nice when you get the class gem, but not of his first character. The Pirate Captain is a no-no, and the Knight is a no-no. It's not a no-no in that sense, but these classes that I said no, that you shouldn't take as a first one, is not bad, but they should be something you do if you have leveled up or gemmed up or whatever, perfected the other characters, then you should go for those if you can. So lastly, I'm taking the Shadow Hunter, and I'm taking this last because it's probably one of the best classes out there. Because of when they have, it's so tedious. It's the worst class to level up when you don't have the class gem for it. As soon as you get its class gem, the Shadow Hunter's class gem, then you are golden. It's so fun to kill everything with it, but it's so tedious to level up. And because I can actually show you, if I switch to this, and I. How it works is that you have your number 2 ability, which I can't really use right now, but it empowers my right mouse button. So what it does is that I have to hold it in. You can see I like load up and have to hold for 1 second, and then I release and I shoot a strong shot. This is very nice. It can one-shot like bosses and whatever and stuff like that, and that's very nice, but it tends to bug out. And suddenly, even though if a boss is like right in front of you and you're standing like this, it sometimes doesn't hit it and does you no damage. If you're in the lower and you're trying to push like Uberworlds, it's really, really long. But when you do get the class gem, it does this when you just auto attack. You just shoot like a freaking machine gun and you do so much damage and you farm so fast. So definitely when you get the class gem for the Shadow Hunter, then it becomes a very, very good class, one of the best. It's my second now, but I also leveled the Boom Ranger first, and then I took the Shadow Hunter. I have all the classes at level 20. 30 is the new max. It takes quite a long time. My Boom Ranger is 30, but the rest of the gang is only 20, and the Shadow Hunter, as you can see, is 24. So that was a little guide to which class you should pick. I hope you liked this video. If you did, put a like on the like button. That would be amazing. And also maybe a comment on something. You have any questions or anything like that? Or you want to see more of a Trove video? And I just want to say thank you so much for tuning in. And I hope to see you in the next video. Swoohoo.